Hello students, in this video I am going to discuss the questions from the subject strength of materials which were asked in MBS 2018. Question number 1. At a point in the wave of a girder, the bending stress sigma x is 3 MPa tensile and the shearing stress tau at the same point is 2 MPa. Then the maximum shear stress is. Now here, in order to get the correct option or correct answer, I want to use the Mohr circle method. Now if I draw the strain element is going to be like this. Sigma x is given, which is 3 MPa. Sigma y is not given. Simply it means that it is 0 and shear stress is 2 MPa. Now we know that in Mohr circle, direct stress is to be plotted along x axis, whereas the shear stress is to be plotted along y axis. Sigma x is given as 3 MPa. So to certain suitable scale, plot sigma x, that is along x axis, and which is equal to 3 MPa. Now sigma y is 0, so it will indicate this point. So this is sigma x and sigma y is 0. Now at this position again, erect tau, that is shear stress, which is equal to 2 MPa. Erect 2 MPa at this position also. Now after erecting these two values to certain suitable scale, join these two together. The midpoint is going to be the center of Mohr circle. So consider this point as the center and radius is equal to this inclined distance and draw a circle. So it is going to be a Mohr circle over here. Now it is asked to get the maximum value of shear stress. Maximum value of shear stress is to be obtained from this point, and this vertical distance is the maximum value of shear stress. It is going to be equal to the radius of the Mohr circle. So radius can be obtained by using Pythagoras theorem. This distance is 1.5 because the value of sigma x is 3 and it is going to be half of that, so it is 1.5. shear stress is 2 MPa. So knowing these two sides, the hypotenuse of this right angle triangle can be obtained using Pythagoras theorem. R is equal to root of 1.5 square plus 2 square, so it is root of 6.25, and which is equal to 2.5 MPa. Option 3 is the correct option. Next question. A beam of length 10 meter carries a uniformly distributed load of 20 kilonewton per meter over its entire length and rests on two simple supports. In order that the maximum bending moment produced in the beam is the least possible, the supports must be placed from the ends at a distance of, and the four options are given. In order to get the correct option, let us draw the figure first. So the figure will be like this. It is going to be a two overhang beam, and let the length of each overhang is x. Now the entire length of the beam is 10 meter. The UDL running over the entire span is 20 kilonewton per meter. As such, the total load will be 20 into 10, that is 200, and that is why the reactions at the supports are going to be 100 kilonewton each. If I draw the bending moment diagram for this beam, the bending moment diagram will be of this type, with the maximum hogging bending moment is appearing at the two supports. So this is the maximum hogging bending moment, and at the middle of the beam there will be a maximum sagging bending moment. Now again, the interesting thing to be noted over here is that if I move the supports towards one another, or if I move the supports closer to one another, it will result in increasing the length of the overhangs, and if the length of the overhang increases, the hogging bending moment also increases. So there will be an increase in hogging bending moment if the supports are brought closer to one another. If the hogging bending moment increases, it will result in decrease in sagging bending moment. On the contrary, if the supports are moved away from one another, it will result in decrease in length of the overhang. If the length of the overhang decreases, the hogging bending moments will also decrease. And decrease in hogging bending moment will result in increase in sagging bending moment. So these two are opposite to one another. Again, they have asked to get the maximum bending moment produced in the beam and which should be least possible. Now, maximum bending moment. The question is which maximum bending moment? Sagging maximum bending moment or hogging maximum bending moment? The answer is we will have to consider both of these. Both of these should have the least possible value. And this condition is satisfied only when the hogging bending moment is equal to sagging bending moment, because increase in hogging bending moment results in decreasing the sagging bending moment, and increase in sagging bending moment results in decreasing the hogging bending moment. And that is why to get the least possible value of bending moment, we'll have to consider that hogging bending moment is equal to sagging bending moment. So hogging bending moment is at the support, and it can be obtained as 20 into x into x by 2, which is 10x square. And it, as it is hogging, I am putting a negative sign over there, is equal to sagging bending moment. It is going to appear at the midpoint of the beam. So if I take a section at the midpoint, the bending moment will be minus 20 into 5 into 2.5. So 20 into 5, 5 meter is the distance of the midpoint. So 20 into 5 into 2.5, it is anti-clockwise, and that is why it is negative. Plus 100 into, now I am taking a section at the midpoint, 100 into this distance, which will be 5 minus x. And if I simplify it further, the equation gets reduced to x square plus 10x minus 25 is equal to 0. And we know how to get the roots of a quadratic equation. Using that formula, minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a, if I substitute the values of b and b, a and c, it will be minus b, so it is minus 10, plus or minus root of b square is 10 square, which is 100, minus 4, a is 1, into c is minus 25. So 25 into 4 is 100, and a minus minus it will be plus, and it will be root of 200. Root of 200 is 14.14. Now rejecting the negative values, the positive value of x will be 4.14 divided by 2, and the correct option for this problem is 2.07, that is option number 4. Next question, choose the correct relation between modulus of elasticity E, modulus of rigidity G, and bulk modulus K from the following. The four options are given. Now in the previous question paper, that is MES 2017, we have proved one relation. E is equal to 9 kg divided by 3 k plus g. So this equation can be rearranged like this. 1 upon E is equal to 3 k plus g divided by 9 kg. So 1 upon E is equal to dividing each and every term of the numerator by the denominator, 3 k divided by 9 kg, g divided by 9 kg. So it becomes 1 upon E is equal to 1 upon 3 g plus 1 upon 9 k. Now multiplying the numerator throughout the equation, it will be 9 by E is equal to 3 by G plus 1 upon K. So option B or option 2 is the correct option. Next question. In a simple bending theory, one of the assumptions is that the material of the beam is isotropic. The assumption means that the. Now we know that an isotropic material is the material in which elastic constants are same in all the directions. And that is why option 3 is the correct option. Next question. A simply supported beam of length L carries a point load W at point C, as shown in the figure. The maximum deflection lies at. Now here we can see that it is a simply supported beam with load W, which is acting at point C. AC is small a and CB is a small b. And we can see from the figure that B is greater than A. Now we also know that in such cases, the maximum deflection is going to appear near the midspan. And we can see that the midpoint is in the part BC, and that is why maximum deflection is going to be in between points B and C. The correct option is option number 4. Next question. In the torsion equation, the torsion equation is given. T by J is equal to tau by R is equal to C theta upon L. The term J by R is called as. It is a simple question. The term J by R in the torsion equation is called as polar modulus, and that is why option 3 is the correct option. Next question. Two solid shafts A and B are made of the same material. The shaft A is of 50 mm diameter and shaft B is of 100 mm diameter. The strength of shaft B is dash 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 of that of shaft A. Now here it is asked to compare the strength of shaft B and strength of shaft A. Now again, in order to compare it, let us see what is the strength of the shaft first. Now strength of the shaft is the maximum torque that can be transmitted by a shaft. Now we have got the equation of torsion as T upon J is equal to tau by R, and therefore T is equal to tau by R into J. So T is proportional to J by R. Now see here, the two shafts are there, the material is going to be same. So shear stress, the value of shear stress is going to be same for the material in this case, and that is why torque that can be transmitted can be considered as proportional to J by R. So T is proportional to pi by 32 into D raised to 4 divided by D by 2, and T is proportional to D cube if the material is same. So T is proportional to D cube, and that is why TB divided by TA is equal to DB cube divided by DA cube. Now DB is 2 times the diameter of the shaft A, and that is why it will be 2 cube, which is 8, and the correct option is option number 4. Next question, the shear force on a simply supported beam is proportional to. The four options are given, but we know that shear force is the algebraic sum of the transverse forces, and that is why option 4 is the correct option, which is algebraic sum of the transverse forces. So option 4 is the correct option. Next question, deflection of the free end of cantilever having point load at the mid span is, and four options are given. Now if I draw the figure will be like this. It is, let it be a cantilever ABC. The point B is the midpoint of this cantilever, and a load is applied, let's say the load W is applied at this midpoint, and it is asked to get the deflection at C. Now in order to get the deflection at C, what I am doing is that, let us consider this beam. It is a cantilever beam AB, let the load W is applied at the free end, and we know the formulae for slope and deflection at point B, that is at the free end. Theta B is equal to W square divided by 2EI, and delta B, that is deflection at B in this case, is WL cube divided by 3EI. Now here in this case it is asked to get the deflection at point C. In order to get the deflection at point C, so what I am doing is that I am going to get the deflection at B. So deflection at C is nothing but deflection at B plus this additional deflection, which is delta dash. Now this delta dash can be obtained from this triangle, because we know that as the load is applied over here, part BC is going to remain straight. So part BC will be tangential at the position B. And if I take the tangent ratio, tan of theta B, it will be equal to D dash divided by L by 2. So tan of theta B is equal to D dash divided by L by 2. And D dash, or that is delta dash, is equal to L by 2 into tan of theta B. Again, theta B is very small, and that is why delta dash can be written as L by 2 into theta B. Deflection at C, that is delta C, is equal to delta B plus delta dash. Delta B, using this formula, I can write it as W into L. Instead of L, it will be L by 2 cube divided by 3i plus theta B into L by 2. Theta B is again WL square divided by 2EI. Instead of L, I will have to write W into L by 2 square divided by 2EI. So this is theta B, this is L by 2, and this I have simplified it over here, because W into L by 2 cube, 2 cube is 8, 8 into 3 is 24. The final value will work out to be 5 WL cube divided by 48EI, and that is why the correct option is option 3. Next question, an element in a strained body is subjected to only shear stress of intensity 50 MPa tending to rotate the body in clockwise direction. What is the magnitude of principal stresses? Now here again I am going for Mohr circle method. If the strained element is to be shown, the strained element will be like this. Only a shear stress is acting, no direct stress. Now if a Mohr circle is to be drawn, it can be drawn like this. Now along y axis we plot the shear stress, along z x axis the
direct stress is to be plotted, but there is no direct stress. So sigma x is 0 as well as sigma y is 0. Sigma x is 0, sigma y is 0. Only shear stress is to be shown. So 50 MPa on positive side, 50 MPa on negative side. Consider this point as the center and radius is equal to 50 MPa and draw a circle. So it is going to be a Mohr circle for this given condition. And from the Mohr circle, it is quite clear that this is the principal stress, which is plus 50 MPa. It is also the principal stress, which is minus 50 MPa. So it is the major principal stress, it is the minor principal stress, and the correct option is plus or minus 50 MPa. Next question, strain energy stored in a solid shaft due to application of torque T at free end while other end is fixed. If G is shear modulus, J is polar moment of inertia, and L is the length of the shaft, will be. Now we know the standard formula for strain energy stored in case of a solid shaft due to application of torque, and which is given as T square L divided by 2 times GJ, and the correct option is option 4.